fishing. Today we are going to do a review on ugly stik elite graphite. You heard about that, eh? Ugly stik, Shakespeare ugly stik elite graphite medium action, and that's my favorite rod, and that's what I'm enjoying for the last 2 years. Never had a problem, and I bought a combo with the bait caster. So man, that's my life, and that's what I'm enjoying. And I would really love to give a review of the same rod I've been using for two years plus. So basically it's going to be 3 years, I guess. So I bought this stuff whenever it came to the market, and I'm enjoying, and it's called Ugly Stik, Shakespeare Ugly Stik Elite Graphite. Hello guys, we're gonna start from one end, and this is what I'm gonna start with, the fiber optic tip. It will give you the feeling of it's gonna amplify. If the fish touch your line or your hook, it's gonna amplify that into a million times, and you get the feeling of a nibbling at your fingertip with the ugly stik elite graphite fiber optic tip. And it looks so nice, and it's so strong. I'm definitely 100% a fan of ugly stik elite graphite, and it comes with it's a medium action, so it's long enough. It comes with a bait caster, and I'm using a 50 pound line, braided line, and I never had a problem. It's gonna do the trick. And if you are actually fishing in some ice cold water, there's a tendency that your line gonna get icy, and it will strike the line. So make sure you don't, if you're fishing ice cold water, make sure to put some monofilament lines in there, so it will make your life easy, because these are braided lines, and it's gonna get icy very faster. So that is the bait caster, and you can, this is the line tension. Make sure you put that ice tension, or I mean the line tension, to the medium, in between the maximum and the low, so that you can cast out to the desired location or the spot. So all you have to do is make sure how much you want your hook, I mean, or your lure to go, and make sure you adjust that with accordingly. And this is for your this knob here is for you to adjust how much tension you need on the line. When you're using an ugly stik with the bait caster, your line should be, or if you're putting a lure on the tip of your rod, it should be fall freely, but not like it should not be dropping that fast, but it should freely fall. So you have to adjust this knob here, and this one is for you to reel in, and this one, the same thing, it's gonna adjust this button right behind your reeling your handle. Is this is for you to actually increase or reduce the line tension. So that's the two thing, and it has got a I think 3 ball bearing for the maximum action. And lubricate your rod once in a while, once in at least 1 month. Use the protocol how to lubricate your reel, and follow that accordingly. Discussed about the bait caster reel. This is a pretty good design with the 3 bearings in there, and this is the one for you to adjust your ice tension, I mean your line tension. And it has got a marvelous handle, and I took off the plastic wrapper from here, and it still works like a pro. And I don't want something very slimy on my handle, like I said in my other video. It always needs to be you should have a firm grip on your rod, and when you cast out, you have to have a finger on your line, so that you can adjust the distance and the exact location where you want your lure to be falling. And this is for you, the ice, the line tension. And make sure you clean out the tip of the bait caster where the line comes out from the reel. It can actually messed with some dirt, and it will actually, if there is a lots of dirt in this small hole where your lines comes out, it can actually damage your line. and make lots of friction on your line. And you have to remember that you have to always keep your rod clean and neat, and this is for you to increase the tension of the reel, and your line should be free falling if you're using, so that you can adjust that here. And the rod is a marvelous finish and a pro, and your it's not going to break. I'm guaranteeing, my guarantee is there that it's not going to break for at least a 60 pound fish. And basic for all line, I'm using a 50 pound line irrespectively. I'm using a 60 pound reader in the tip, so that you know, and always I have this kind of reader here, so you can see that this kind of reader, and I attach always something for the lure to be hooked, so that it will be it will have a nice motion when you are actually reeling that back in. So ugly stick elite graphite is the best rod for beginners and for a pro. And make sure your bait cast is properly maintained, cleaned, get the tear off your the small holes in the front, and your tension should be, line tension should be adjusted accordingly. Make sure you have to have your finger when you're reeling the fish back in, and when you reel, when you're throwing your lure out, make sure you have a finger tip on top of your make sure your thumb should be on the line, so that you can control the distance of your lure, how much it needs to be going and where it needs to be flowing. And it will get a lot of easy when you put the line strength here and here according to your wish, and it should be free flowing all the time. It will go only one direction, it won't rotate anti-clockwise. So it has got a good finish, very good strength, and the most important thing is the fiber optic tip. All hypothetical, if you're using a 50 pound, you can actually make sure you can have at least a 70-80 yards of line in there. So I will recommend this for anybody who would like to buy a new fishing rod for the summer season. And the ugly stik graphite medium action is one of my best fishing rod for years, and I trust on it, and I never missed a fish. I never had a problem with any of the hooks or any of this stuff here. It's all tough, good for fishing. So I will see you guys next time with another review of another material, another fishing gear. Until then, you guys take care, and please don't forget to subscribe to my channel, like, share if you like the information, and we will come back to you next time with a new video. Till then, Dr. Fishing, bye bye.